There is the ijma' of the ijma' that the Zahiris, Dawud al-Zahiri and Ibn Hazm, they say the ijma' is the ijma' of the Sahaba. But they contradict themselves as well. They say the ijma' is the ijma' of the Sahaba, and when the Sahaba gather on something, we have to follow it. Regardless, we know that they're proof or we don't. And Ibn Hazm, when the other people from the other schools, from the other madahib, from the Hanafis, Shafi'is, claim about something that this is ijma', sometimes we will say, oh, this is not ijma', because Hassan al-Basri has said something different. Hassan al-Basri is not Sahabi. So he is agreeing with them that the Sahaba have agreed on it, but he is giving the right to Hassan al-Basri here to contradict them. He doesn't consider it to be right, the ijma' to be right. And he says if the Sahaba agree on something, this is ijma'. So he should have said, yeah, this is ijma', but Hassan al-Basri made a mistake. But no, he will say this is not ijma' because Hassan al-Basri is not included. And sometimes he will say this is not ijma' because Ahmed ibn Hanbal is not included. This is even less than, because Ahmed ibn Hanbal is not even tabi'i, atba' tabi'in. So he contradicted himself in this matter. The ijma' of Ibn Hazm here, before we go that, the people have written books about ijma'. For example, Ibn Hazm has written a book about ijma' called Maratib al-Ijma'. He mentioned a lot of things that he think it's ijma'. They gathered on this, they gathered on this, they gathered. And Ibn Taymiyyah wrote a book called Naqd Maratib al-Ijma'. The book that answers to Ibn Hazm and show where he is wrong. Ibn Hazm will say, this is ijma'. Ibn Taymiyyah will say, no, this is not ijma', because one Sahabi has said something. He will, almost all that book, he made it invalid. And he was writing it. Ibn al-Mundhir wrote a similar book about ijma'. And it's only recently someone has written an answer and with the proofs from the books that someone has said something different to what he said claimed to be ijma'. He mentioned hundreds of things. Actually, he was left with about 50 things. And even that 50 things is, all these things that he mentioned about ijma' is clearly, you can find them clearly in Quran and Sunnah, like prayer, like alcohol to be haram, like things that you can't have, you can't say something different. But how do we know it? Not from the ijma', we know it from Quran and Sunnah. The other thing that Ibn Hazm bring in ijma' for those who have studied Tahiri's madhab, Ibn Hazm say some ijma' he called it the ijma' aqal maqil, the less of what have been said. The less of what have been said. How does he put it? For example, now we know that when we are traveling, some people you say we are allowed, some we say we have to shorten the prayer to 2 rak'ah. But what is the limit? What is the limit of this travel? 1 kilometer, 5, 6. So Ibn Umar, for example, say 1 mile. 1 mile is equal to 1,800 meters, according to that mile, approximately. So Ibn Umar says 1 mile. There are other different madahib. Some say 34, some say 87. So here Ibn Hazm came with something new that nobody said before him, because there are different opinions here. So he said, the ijma' is the less of what have been said. Meaning, that is 1 mile. Why? Because whoever said 3 miles, he said 1 mile plus 2. Whoever said 43 miles, he said 42 plus 1. So they all agreed on one. If we had to take this ijma', this is theory. Religion is not theories. Religion is practice. So if we have to take the ijma', actually, he will be the opposite. It will be the opposite. It will be the most of what has been said. Why? Let's say he says 1 mile. I say 20. He says 40. We start our journey. After 1 mile, he will pray 2 rak'ah. We will pray 4. After 20 miles, we will pray 2 rak'ah. He will pray 4. So from the beginning, there is difference. When we reach 40 miles, we will pray 2 rak'ah. So this is here ijma', the most, not the less. All these just show that these things that they have come with without proof is invalid. We always say that Quran and Sunnah covers everything. The Sahaba, it's impossible. It's impossible that the Sahaba one day will gather and bring a new religion. You see, when they say ijma', how did it come to ijma'? Did they gather and then decided to make something halal haram? Or to make something haram halal? Religion is this: halal, haram, obligation.